Okay, we're going to do some painting, puppy painting today. I have a crafter square here. This is an 8x10 size. I got it at the dollar store. You will want to take the outside covering off to canvas. I have a gallon size Ziploc bag that the canvas will fit inside of. I have some different kinds of paint here. I have squeeze cheese. You can use peanut butter, applesauce, canned pumpkin, anything that is spreadable. You're going to spread that on the bag. And I actually also have a crate tray here, just in case anything should leak out of the bag. We can prevent it from getting all over the place. Okay? So we're going to take our canvas and we're going to put some paint on it. You can use any colors that you want. These do not have a handy squeeze thing on them, which you might prefer to get one with. And you're just going to dab your paint on if you want to make a fancy shape. Can make a fancy shape. You could just glob it on there if you wanted to. I'm trying to make a shape, so I'm using a knife. You can use a paintbrush, but you want to leave it a little globby because you want your dog to actually do some of the painting. Okay, there's my pink. I have some blue. Put some blue around. Oops. That's why we have the tray here. All clean, no problem. And then I have my orange, which does have a little squeezy thing. So it makes it a little easier if you want to. Oh, look, it lets me make some swirls. You want to make shapes. I put the lids on these so I don't make a complete mess. Okay. Then I'm going to put that carefully into the bag. To hold the edges up so you don't smear it. You could also put your peanut butter, your cheese, whatever on the outside of the bag before you do this step. But because I have the squeeze cheese, I don't need to spread it. I'm just going to put some cheese all along my design. you can all see that on the video. Pick it up for you here. So I've got my paint, I've got my cheese. Now I'm going to turn this off and go get my puppy. I'll be right back. Okay, we are back. I have my adorable puppy. She can already smell the cheese. Okay. It's okay if she steps on it because it's inside the bag. Ooh, that was a sticky one. I can add more cheese. There she goes. And as she's licking, she is moving that paint around, smearing that paint around, making her own designs. If there's any areas that she's not getting, I just put a little more cheese to encourage her to lick a little bit more. On this side. She is having a ball and doesn't even know that she's creating this masterpiece. Really focusing on this side of the painting right now. Getting it just to her liking. think she might be satisfied. Let's take a look. And when we're ready to take it out of the bag, open it up. Take a minute, let your top layer peel away from your canvas. You can help it a little there if you need to. Once you've got it up a little bit, you can pull it out. Paint stays in the bag. Have a beautiful puppy canvas, which of course you need to then let dry away from your puppy. So I'm going to put mine up here for now. All right. I hope you have fun. I look forward to seeing your puppy masterpieces. Bye-bye.